My last video explained some of the typical mistakes players make. Most players found it helpful, but some found it offensive. Not because of the hot chicks and bikinis. It was because they didn't agree with me and thought I had the problem understanding. But these players are still chasing their tails, not understanding why their systems lose. I expected that. I could say popular things, and it would make nice bedtime stories, but it wouldn't be the truth. Anyway, let's get started. And if you haven't seen my previous videos, you should go back and see them first. In this video, I'll continue explaining the mistakes players make. Again, don't think you're different, almost every player makes them. And of course, I'll include more videos of gorgeous chicks. How casinos see you depends on your system. If you're an advantage player, it means you're using legitimate science to predict winning numbers. The casino sees you as a threat because you have a real advantage. But if you're a typical player, this is how casinos see you. You're just another clueless one in the crowd. Casinos don't care who wins or loses for the day because they know they have a long-term advantage. They think in terms of tens of thousands of players and over weeks, months and years. This is millions of game results across all different games, not just roulette. So casinos see the larger picture, but players see it very differently. Most casinos allow you to take notes while playing. There are some types of notes that casinos really don't like you taking. I'll explain those another time. But the typical notes players take are pointless. Here are some examples of typical notes. Firstly, the notes usually track patterns that don't really exist, so the data is irrelevant. And secondly, the data is short term. So the casinos know that most notes players take are a joke. To them, it's more about keeping you happy and blissfully unaware. They know if you win for the day, you'll be happy. You'll think your notes and your system worked. So you'll come back another day and probably lose. Now I'll show you the kind of information casinos know. Here's a test of a typical roulette system using the software called Roulette Extreme. Initially, the system works. It looks like the system is working. It even wins over more spins than most people play in their lifetime. This is not because the system is good. It's because it uses betting progression. So it increases the size of bets after losses in attempt to recover losses. But like I said in a previous video, betting progression is like a loan that must be eventually repaid with interest. You win for a while, then lose big. So betting progressions only delay the inevitable. Like most systems, this one uses elaborate calculations to determine when and where to bet. 1 million spins were tested and we can see what happened. Pay attention to the statistics, especially the net percentage. If the system was completely ineffective, we expect it to be around -2.7%. That's because it's the house edge for European roulette. In tests like this, I call the net percentage the resulting edge. Remember this term because I'll refer to it throughout the video. The resulting edge isn't exactly the system's edge, it's just the end result of the test. So with random bets, or if the system is completely ineffective, we expect the resulting edge to be about -2.7%. But even after 1 million spins, we'll rarely get exactly 2.7. It might be 2.8, 2.4 or whatever, but it's still around 2.7. This slight variation from the expected result is called variance. In this case, it was -2.85. So what does this mean? It means this system's bet selection method was completely ineffective. It was no better than random bets. It changed nothing. But if it changed nothing, then why did the bankroll increase for so long? It's because betting progression was used. Again, betting progression is like a loan that must be repaid with interest. So progression keeps you winning for a while. You can do the same with any type of bet. This includes random bets on red, black, odds, even, streets, squares, splits, single numbers, or whatever. The only difference is each type of bet has different odds, but they all still have unfair payouts. Now let's run a test to see how the martingale system goes. This is a basic system where you just double bets after losing. You should already know it doesn't work. That's because you either reach the table betting limit or run out of money. But let's see what happens with unlimited money and no betting limits. So we won and the chart looks great, but here's my point. When you see bankroll charts like these, almost always you're just seeing the results of progression betting. It has nothing to do with how accurately your system predicts winning numbers. It has nothing to do with how sophisticated your system is. It's just plain betting progression. It's the same for almost every system. Later in this video, I'll explain how you can confirm this for sure. But first, I'll recap what I'm saying. Forget testing on scrap paper. Forget short-term results. The casino doesn't care about short-term because they know it's irrelevant. Their whole business depends on accurate statistics, and they've done their homework. So you need proper long-term testing to see what your system is really made of. For this, you need the right tools. The software called Roulette Extreme is just one example, but Roulette Extreme has two major downsides. Firstly, it can only test mechanical approaches that lose. For example, after 10 reds in a row, bet black. And secondly, programming it to test custom systems is too complicated for most people. It's like learning a whole new programming language. I personally don't use Roulette Extreme for testing my systems. I use custom-made software. Anyway, before we continue, the key point is if the system is completely ineffective, the resulting edge will be around -2.7% on the European wheel. Now let's run some long-term tests of different systems. So we can see even with different systems, the resulting edge is still around the house edge, which is -2.7%. The players that designed these systems probably thought their system was clever and that it tracks real patterns, but proper testing proves the patterns only existed in their imagination. Importantly, past spins do hold clues to future spins, but only if you're looking at the right thing. The problem is most systems don't look at the right thing. This is not my opinion. Math is not an opinion. Numbers are not an opinion, so please don't send me hate mail or call me a with a you mother. I'm sensitive to that kind of thing. One of the most boneheaded statements players make is I'll never play tens of thousands of spins, so I don't need to test that many spins. I just need a system that wins in the short term. Remember how casinos see typical players. And if you want a system that wins only in the short term, just use random bets with progression. Then you'll win most of the time, but when you lose, you'll lose big. Also, keep in mind, a stop loss won't protect you. If you stop betting, you could be missing out on massive wins, or you could be avoiding losses. Which will it be? You don't know. Every spin is independent, with the payouts always being unfair, even if you do win. Anyway, back to my original point, why long-term tests are needed. If you repeat tests of the same system, but with different spins, often you'll get different results. This is especially if you don't test enough spins. Remember, anything can happen in the short term. Here's the bankroll chart of a test in a previous video. I've broken it into sections of 10,000 spins. The green lines are winning sections and red lines are losing sections. We won in some sections and lost in others. Let's put it into perspective. Say we had 10 different players who each played a different section of 10,000 spins. Some would win, but most would lose. 10,000 spins is more than most people play in their lifetime. But to the casino, because they understand reality, it's still short term. They only care that most players lost. My point is forget about short term. Again, players often say you only need to win in the short term because you'll never play millions of spins. That's not quite true. It's not about how many spins you'll actually play. It's only about odds versus payout, and specifically that payouts are unfair even when you do win. And the house edge affects each and every spin, so you're affected whether you play one spin or 10,000 spins. Let's consider another perspective. Five players won and five players lost, but the combined result is a loss. So if you were one of these players, you'd have a 50% chance of winning. It's just like betting 18 numbers on one spin. It also gives you about a 50% chance of winning. So how's this different? Well, if you bet 18 numbers on one spin, it only takes a few seconds. But if you play 10,000 spins, it takes about a year. So the difference is just time. Players on forums have an unhealthy obsession with long upward trend lines. They would mean something if flat betting was used. These are bets without any progression, but they almost always involve progressions. The shape of trend lines vary between different systems. One system might have a smooth uptrend, and some sharp periods of loss like this. This means the system uses a conservative betting progression. For example, the progression might only aim to win back losses so the bankroll returns to where it was before a losing streak. A more aggressive progression might aim to win back more than previous losses. With more aggressive progression, the bankroll looks more erratic, so you'll have huge up and down swings instead of a smoother line. Also, hang on. I love that chick. Also, your system's bet selection logic contributes to how the trend line looks. For example, your system may require you to bet only after certain triggers, like maybe betting a number when it repeats consecutively, like 32 and 32. In this case, you'll bet only once every 40 or so spins. You'll skip many spins. On a bankroll chart, this looks like your system survived more spins. On the other hand, if your system bet on every spin, then generally your system won't survive as many spins. You might incorrectly think your system is worse, but that's not the case. Keep in mind, a good system is not about surviving spins. A good system is about increasing the accuracy of predictions so your bet selections win more frequently than random bets. If you only want to survive spins, just bet a percentage of your remaining bankroll. Then as you lose, you'll bet less and lose less. Another option, if you only want to survive spins, is just use some kind of betting trigger. For example, you bet only after seeing specific numbers. But in reality, it won't make any difference to your profit. You'll just be delaying the inevitable. This is because when you do bet, the odds of winning and the payouts haven't changed. Systems can use countless combinations of bet selection algorithms and progressions. These are what you probably think define your system and make it different to other systems. These factors determine how your bankroll chart will look, like a smoother line, a more erratic line with dramatic ups and downs, or whatever. Generally, the simpler your system is, the more predictable the trend line looks, and the more complicated your system is, the more erratic the trend line is. My point is, different systems produce different trend lines and different repeating patterns in trend lines. So people think one system is different to another, but in reality, almost all systems are a repackaged mess of random bets. You might think your system uses solid logic to know when and where to bet, and you might think your progression is a good money management strategy. But in the end, almost every system is nothing more than random bets with random bet size. You might think it's not random because your system follows logic, but again, your win rate is still random, so your system changed nothing. You can easily prove this by testing about 1 million spins, then checking the resulting edge. I know this will upset some people, but when you understand how to properly test and what the results mean, the truth is clear. I'll give another example. If you made random bets with random bet size without any other rules, then your trend line would look very erratic. You'll have parts where it's smooth, parts with a strong up or downtrend, and parts where it's all over the place. But in the end, your resulting edge will be around negative 2.7%. So your sophisticated betting strategy and time to develop the system counted for nothing. Again, it's not my opinion. Do proper testing for yourself. Now let's put it into context. Like I explained in previous videos, every single spin is an independent event. Each and every spin has its own odds of winning. Like with a single number, the odds on a European wheel are 1 in 37. So no matter what patterns you think you see, if your bets have random accuracy, you'll still average 1 win per 37 spins. So your system changed nothing. And any wins or losses in the past days, weeks, months, or even years were just luck. It doesn't mean your system works. I know money is money. It's good if you've won. But as you've seen in my videos, you must realistically test millions of spins to know for sure if your system is any better than random bets. And again, winning roulette is not about surviving spins. It's not about winning most of the time either. Because you can have a series of small wins, then a massive loss. Refer back to my earlier videos. If you're only trying to win in your lifetime or career as a gambler, then forget about elaborate bet selection logic. Just focus on conservative betting progression. In this case, what you bet isn't important, because again, your win rate is still the same as random. Your betting progression should only aim to recover losses, so your bankroll returns to a new all-time high. At least that's what I'd suggest if you're a gambler. But if you want to earn a living from roulette, then I'd suggest something very different. I'd suggest focusing on bet selection methods that actually change things. Specifically, they should increase the accuracy of your predictions so you win more frequently than random bets. I realize parts of this video might be confusing to some people. It's not that the logic is complicated. It's because it's hard to get your head around concepts that conflict with your brain. We naturally try to make sense of random information. We think we see patterns that don't really exist. More specifically, we see patterns that make sense to us, but have absolutely no effect on future spins. So when we place bets on incorrect perception, we lose, because the bets still have random accuracy, and the payouts are still unfair. Again, it's not my opinion, it's what simple testing proves. In the next video, I'll explain more typical mistakes players make, but I'll get right down to the problems of specific strategies and misunderstandings. They're like cancers on gambling forums. For example, principles like the law of a third. There are many others too. If everyone did the testing I've explained here and checked the resulting edge, they'd know if a system was any better than random bets. And do the testing with flat bets, not progression. That's because if a system doesn't win with flat bets, it won't win with progression. Remember, progression is just different size bets on different spins. The amount you bet doesn't change the odds or the fact that the payouts are unfair, even when you do win. So there's just one more video explaining the basics, which most players are still stuck on. After that video, I'll start explaining some of the strategies that really work. I mean the systems that can earn you a living playing roulette. Remember to subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon so you're notified of new videos. We'll be right back.